Hi guys, happy new year. We've not seen you in a while. Welcome to another segment of Prosecco and Nuts. There's the Prosecco, here are the nuts. And we are at wonderful Revolve Furnishings Calgary, beautifully decorated. And you can come down here and check out some fantastic furniture as well. We are going to be talking about the awards season.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So finally, a few awards have passed, and we're going to get everyone's takes on some of the things that have happened. So let's start off with the Golden Globes that happened earlier. Now, obviously, is that why you ladies are wearing black today? Well, I know you're always wearing black.
We're always wearing black, so we are on trend for the Golden Globes.
Well, let's start with the red carpet.
Right.
And that was the talk of the red carpet, was that all of the women were wearing all black.
Oh, great. Yeah.
Right? Even, the guys were, too.
Yeah.
Which I thought was great that everybody came together like that, but I have one thing to say. Oh, even though I love black, I was so disappointed that they didn't step it up with either jewelry or cool shoes or some, make a statement. I mean, if you're gonna wear black, at least have a little bit of jewelry, a little bit of bling, a little bit of something. Mm-hmm. I just thought that, I just thought that the whole show was blah for it being black. I thought, and you know what, I'll give them a little pass because I think all the Americans are highly depressed because of their government. So,
so do we blame them?
So
if you're in orange leading the new black,
I feel like
come on, nobody likes that.
I feel like they're in mourning. So,
but there was a statement to be made. Right. So I guess it wasn't necessarily to be overt with your.
Right.
You pretty much wanted people to state, okay, let's take note of what's happening with regards to.
Yes, and I totally agree with that. But at least put on a big ass necklace that's blingy
or some kind of
next
time invite Flavor Flav
and wear your clock.
Okay, so let's talk about some of the highlights. There had to be some that you did like.
So I'm just gonna say first off, a highlight is that everybody was wearing black.
Yes.
The reason and the purpose aside, finally people didn't look like 7-year-olds on a runway, on a red carpet, at an award show with the superstars of the world. They make crazy choices sometimes. We've seen some. We're going to talk about some. Mm-hmm. But at least in black, those crazy choices become a little bit more acceptable.
Okay, so what were your favorites? Let's go there. Liz?
I'm going to give my first one, I think, to Mariah Carey. Excuse me.
She never wears a different dress. It's the same goddamn dress in different colors. It's all, ooh, I'm a mermaid with 16 specs underneath.
When her body is changing like that, that's the only thing you're allowed to wear.
You're trying to tell me about a changing body? I am 28 years older than you, goddammit. I take kids out my freaking system.
She's half black. Well, I guess you are too.
Right? What is your excuse?
Well, I don't know. I thought she looked great. Okay, my second choice is going to be Allison Janney. And my third is my homegirl, Oprah Winfrey.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Those are gorgeous.
We're definitely going to talk about Oprah and the Golden Globes, but let's talk about just the red carpet.
Okay, so
VR, your top picks?
My top picks are
not
Kelly's
Mariah Carey.
Worst picks. Not Mariah. Come on, Mariah. I loved Angelina Jolie's lingerie look with her.
It's like something your grandma would wear.
It's like something Elizabeth Taylor would have worn.
Absolutely.
Like, way back.
Absolutely. I do think it looked like Elizabeth Taylor.
And they plucked a chicken and glued it at the bottom.
That was Heidi Klum. You are completely
confused. No, I didn't. Oh, my word. Look at that chicken right there.
Okay, but let me tell you, the old Hollywood, I liked that because she is a movie star. She's not a celebrity.
Not anymore.
No, she has taken a step back. But if you look at the caliber of movie stars out there, there aren't many movie stars anymore.
Okay.
And she looked like a movie
star.
Listen,
honey, she is single. She needs to be working that.
No, she needs to eat a cheeseburger.
She needs a cheeseburger.
She ain't getting no dates with that bone skeleton sister. No dates.
Skeletor.
Besides that,
Sarah Jessica Parker, I thought she looked adorable. She looked really, really cute and fresh, but not too immature. He hated her again.
She looks like a horse.
We're not talking about her face. We're talking about her wardrobe.
I am not a Sex and the City fan, and I'll probably lose my gay card for that.
Yeah,
but
you are.
I'm pulling it right now.
Yeah.
I'm pulling that card. And then I also really liked Nicole Kidman for a change. Because I haven't liked her in the past few Prosecco and Nuts shows we have done. Yeah. I have not liked her, and I liked her at the Golden Globes, probably because her silly ass dresses, it was black. So it looked good in black.
Yeah. Okay, Kelly Arrow.
Yeah.
Okay, so back to the old Hollywood. One of my favorites was Alison Brie.
Yes.
Very Audrey Hepburn. Mm-hmm. Love the dress, love the cut. And my little crush, Mandy Moore. Love her.
Stupid. It's a high school prom dress.
You're talking, but she had the pop of red. She had the color.
And she did match it perfectly with the red carpet. Because I feel like when you have to have red, you have to match it perfectly.
Yeah,
with
but
the
black and red is so old school 80s. It's like, true. Come on, man.
And Jessica Biel. I love the dress. That was a good one.
You know what? It's a little Cirque du Soleil for
me.
Yeah,
I don't like
it. It's true, but it was different. Yeah.
So we can agree that nobody agreed.
Nobody agreed.
Oprah looked good.
Except Oprah.
Oprah looked amazing.
We all loved how Oprah looked.
You can never say anything bad about Oprah.
She looked good. She spoke
well. But you shouldn't.
You shouldn't.
Okay.
Yeah,
and
but
so
she looked good.
Any lowlights that we had on there? And then like, literally the what the heck are you wearing?
Okay. My worst lowlight was, she was my favorite dress last year, was the Millie Bobby Brown. Terrible. She was in Calvin Klein. Mm-hmm. And
I thought she was cute. I mean, from the back, I thought was great.
Okay.
I liked it from the back, but from the front, I agree. It wasn't that good.
Yeah, it wasn't ideal. Mm-hmm. I also really did not enjoy Heidi Klum's Carpet Girl superhero look.
She's always a hot mess.
She is a hot mess.
For somebody who's a model, she's...
She has got shit for style.
Yeah,
like, shit. I don't know who's dressing her.
Yeah.
You need to hire me, Heidi.
Yeah,
I'm just saying, you are a smoke show, and you're wearing a carpet to the red carpet.
Yeah,
do you get that?
Awful. Yeah. It's terrible. Every year we talk about her.
Was there one other one that you have?
She kills it at Halloween.
I'm good with mine. Like I said, I wasn't impressed with anybody except for Oprah.
Yeah, I wasn't overly impressed.
Yeah,
by
black,
anyone,
everyone disappointed me on black. I was super excited to see what was going to happen.
I don't think, again, we were supposed to be impressed. I think. And
it was a
statement. This is
Listen,
the non-fashion
okay, you know
dude.
What? When I go to a funeral. I go to a funeral.
Okay,
there is
much.
Like no. When you dress
much.
In black, you need to bring a little bit of style, and I feel like you.
So the funeral?
Yeah, I do. You see me at my dad's funeral wearing a feather hat.
You were.
I was
like a peacock.
I was.
Yeah.
You didn't miss me.
Okay.
I wonder if it's these stars. They go to so many amazing events, and you know the jewelry, the everything. I just don't know if they think it's. Wow anymore.
Well, you know what?
I don't know.
One of the designers did say they only had 2.5 weeks to prepare. So everyone had their outfits selected. Mm-hmm.
Two and a half weeks to prepare?
Yeah.
It's
okay, don't
long.
Get me involved in that. If you can't pick an outfit in 2.5 weeks, you need to...
No, they had to be custom made.
It doesn't matter to me.
Well, I'm not giving any excuse, but I'm just...
Yeah. This is a married man who doesn't want to wait 45 minutes as well to pick out a dress. You did it 2.5 weeks? Stop it. Okay.
Stop it.
I think that's enough of that.
Do we need to talk the political?
No.
How do we feel?
Well, we're
going to
get into the show. We're going to get into the show.
Okay.
So we'll come
back
in our next segment. We're going to actually talk about some of the show highlights and lowlights more on the Golden Globes from Prosecco and Nuts coming up.